my jackets. Wish you all a very happy, healthy and prosperous new year. Happy new year, dears. Jackets, how was your vacation? Did you enjoy your Christmas holidays? Did you celebrate your Christmas and new year? I hope you enjoyed your holidays well. Welcome back to today's English class. Before starting our new lesson, let me ask a few questions. Are you ready to answer it? Jess, have you ever seen dolphins in real life or on the television? Where do they live? Yes, we know that. They live in water. They are water animals. The dolphins are water animals. Where do you find them? They are found in oceans. We already heard that the dolphins are very intelligent and friendly. Dears, today we are going to learn our fourth lesson, Jomo and the Dolphin. In this lesson, we can see a boy, Jomo, who spotted a dolphin. This story describes how did Jomo and the dolphin become good friends. How did dolphin help Jomo? Let's start this lesson. Dear kids, take your textbook and listen carefully. Dear children, take your textbook and take the page number 25. Lesson 4, Jomo and the Dolphin. It was a warm summer morning. The sun was shining brightly on the little town of Hippo in North Africa. Jomo rubbed his eyes, yawned and stretched his arms after a night's sleep. Here we can see a boy whose name is Jomo. Where did he live, Jomo? He lived in the little town of Hippo in North Africa. Jomo, he lived in the little town of Hippo in North Africa. What was the climate there? Yes, very hot. Listen here, dears. It was a very hot day. On this day, the sun was shining very brightly. Yes, it was a summer season. Very hot day it was. The sun was shining brightly on the little town. What was the name of this town? Yes, Hippo. Where was it? It was in North Africa. Jomo, he lived in the little town of Hippo in North Africa. He woke up in the morning. What did he do then? Yes, he rubbed his eyes, yawned and stretched his arms after a night's sleep. Yes, we are also doing all these things after sleep. Jomo, he also did all these things. What? He rubbed his eyes, yawned and stretched his arms after a night's sleep. What did he do next? Let's see. Let me go for a swim. It is so warm today, Jomo thought. He ran to the river, flowing close to his house. To his joy, he found many of his friends down by the river. Jomo, he woke up in the morning and he told to himself that it is very hot today. I must go for a swim. I want to go for swimming. Yes, Jomo, he wanted to go for swimming. Where? To the river. Near his house, there was a river. He wanted to go there to swim. He went there to swim. He became very happy because when he reached there, he could see his friends there. Jomo, he woke up in the morning and he wanted to go for a swim where to the river. Near his house, there was a river. He went there to swim. He met his friends there. Let's have a swimming competition, they said. The boy who swam the farthest from the shore was to win a prize. The competition began and the boys started swimming. Some of them went very far into the river. Jomo, he met his friends down by the river and he became very happy. Jomo's friends planned to conduct a swimming competition. Who will win the prize? The boy who swam the farthest from the shore was to win the prize. Those who swim far from the shore will get the prize. The competition began. The boys started to swim to get the prize. Some boys went very far into the river forward to get the prize. All of a sudden, Jomo saw something swimming in front of him. It seemed too large to be any of his friends. He swam a little closer and found that it was a dolphin. Jomo, he also swam very fast to get the prize. When he was swimming very fast, he saw something swimming in front of him. Jomo, he understood that it was not his friend because it was too large. Too large means too big. What did he do? Jomo, he wanted to know what it was. So he swam a little closer and found that it was a dolphin. Yes, Jomo, he understood that it was a dolphin. Jomo saw something in front of him. What it was? It was a dolphin. It was very big. It was a big dolphin. Jomo knew that dolphins belonged to the whale family. He was frightened and swam away from the huge animal. The dolphin followed him wherever he went. He shouted to his friends for help, but they were too far away. The dolphin swam around him for some time. It then dived under Jomo, came up from below him and suddenly took him on its back. Jomo, he saw a dolphin in the river. He understood that it was very big. Yes, the dolphin was very big. He came to know that what is the dolphins belong to the whale family. Do you know what is the whale? Yes, it's a water animal. It is very big and it will attack others. Jomo heard that dolphins belong to whale family. He was afraid and he swam away from the huge animal. Who's that huge animal? Yes, dolphin. He wanted to escape from the sight of this dolphin. So he swam away. But the dolphin followed him where Jomo was going. Yes, the dolphin followed him wherever he went. What did he do? Jomo shouted to his friends for help. The frightened Jomo shouted. He called his friends loudly for help. Did they hear his voice? No, his friends were not listening to him because they were very far away. Jomo, he wanted to escape. What did he do? Yes, he called his friends loudly, but they couldn't hear his voice because they were too far away. Jomo, he was very afraid. No one of his friends came to help him. The dolphin swam around Jomo. Then it dived. What's the meaning of dive? Dive means to jump into the water. The dolphin jumped into the water and came up from below Jomo. Suddenly, the dolphin took Jomo on its back. Where was Jomo? Jomo was sitting on its back. The dolphin, it dived under Jomo and took him on its back. The dolphin shook its head at Jomo and seemed to say, "Don't be afraid, little boy. I won't harm you. I'm your friend." Jomo held on to the dolphin tightly and the dolphin carried the little boy on its back for a ride in the river. Where was Jomo now? Yes, Jomo was sitting on dolphin's back. The dolphin shook its head. What's the meaning of shook? Shook means to turn its head from side to side. Dolphin shook its head at Jomo in a friendly manner. It seemed to say, "Don't be afraid, little boy. I won't harm you. I'm your little friend." Yes. The dolphin says, "What? Don't be afraid. I'm your friend. I won't harm you. I won't attack you. Don't worry." Jomo, he was okay now and he held on to the dolphins tightly. Yes, the dolphin carried the little boy on its back for a ride in the river. Yes, they became friends. The dolphin carried Jomo on its back and they went for a ride in the river. Jomo and the dolphin became very good friends. They loved each other so much that the dolphin came every day at the same time and took Jomo for a ride in the lovely river. Jomo and dolphin became very good friends. Jomo and the dolphin became very good friends. They loved each other very much. The dolphin came every day at the riverside to meet Jomo. And what did they do? Yes, dolphin took Jomo for a ride in the lovely river. Is it clear, dears? Jomo and dolphin became very good friends. And every day they met at the riverside. And the dolphin took Jomo for a ride in the lovely river. Dears, now I'm going to introduce a few new words for you. Listen here. First word is yarn. First one is yarn. Next one, competition. Second one is competition. Third one, huge. Third one, huge. Next one, died. Last one is ride. Dears, try to read all these words. First one, yard.
Next one, competition. Then huge, dived, ride. Okay, good. Just hope you understood today's class. It's the time to wind up today's class. See you in the next class. Bye. Thank you.